as you can see, the ears are actually divided into external, mid-ear, and inner ear, right? The external ear is, this is called pinna, or external ear is fine. And this is called external auditory meatus. That is ear canal. If you want to just say canal, that's fine. But there is a tympanic membrane that separates the external ear to mid-ear. So, tympanic membrane right here.
Did you say the drum? It's
the
tympanic membrane?
Yeah. So that is the eardrum. Eardrum. Now, eardrums are connected to these ossicles. Obviously, they are called stapes, incus, malleus, and incus. And those are, the stapes are the last ones. Because they are designed to convert the sound into, the tympanic membrane converts the sound into vibration. And that vibration is amplified by these three ossicles. Evolutionally, they are very unique because they are actually the remnants of your laryngeal slit, the arch that was shaping it, have evolved, ultimately moved in, and became that. So it's evolutionally very important, interesting bones. But those are bones. Tiny bones are called ossicles. Now, this ultimately leads into and this one, it's really hard to see, but here, you can actually see right here, and that is, this is the stage right here, and 27 in this one pointing is called oval window. So it is vibrating the whole structure that is called, these are called cochlea, and this is called seminiferous tubule. Semicircular tubules, Now, seminiferous tubules are found in test tubes. So, these are designed to detect balance. Cochlea is designed to hear. And that's where is an organ of corti that actually the vibration is now detected. And the basal membrane is actually vibrating. And these hair cells are located, and it gets stretched. The stretching of the hair cells converts into the electrical impulse. Yes?
The function of the semicircular tubules is?
Balance. So that this region is called ampulla. And, but anyhow, so that structure that you should look at. So, tracing the sound. So sound comes in, and that's what we have ear. What's the purpose or function of ear? Gathering of sound wave. So sound wave will travel to the external auditory meatus, and it vibrates the tympanic membrane or eardrum, and that vibration, so conversion of sound wave into vibration. And that vibration is detected by these small ossicles or the ear bones, and that is amplified. And it is vibrating the oval window, and when the oval window is vibrated, that vibration, depending upon different wavelength, will actually vibrate the basal membrane of the different region of the cochlea. And that vibration pulls the hair of the hair cell. And that pulling, that mechanical pulling is converted into electrical impulse, just like action potential that we just talked about. And it travels through your auditory nerve and ultimately goes into your temporal lobe and processed as sound. So you hear the ringing of sound, ringing in the ear, you're not actually hearing it, you're just simply processing something that you're not hearing. So have you ever had that experience that your girlfriend calls your name and you turn around and she's not there? Or maybe your ex-husband collecting or whatever. But you never had that experience?
Like think somebody's calling me,
yeah.
Or I hear something.
Yeah, I was using that example. Same thing, like you walk and you somehow you see somebody, and then you go like this and you don't see them. Never.
Maybe I'm psychotic. Mm-hmm.
But anyway, so what I'm trying to say is sometimes what you not hear, what you hear might not be what you're hearing.
So what happens when you're deaf, like deaf people?
There are different levels. One is obviously their mechanical defect, where the tympanic membrane is ruptured and deformed, or your ossicles are deformed. So in those cases, depending upon the severity, they can actually have surgeries to actually heal your tympanic membrane, as well as having the artificial body parts, and actually they still do. Those things you could actually modify, whereas processing might not be happening, then you cannot. Same thing with vision as well. So now, people who have the impairment because of the lack of the sensory organ, now we believe that we're ready to have a bionic person, where they are able to detect and see. And we have the technology to actually modify and form the shape, literally. Sending a signal to the nerve endings, so they can hear. And even now, in sound, same thing. So they actually embed these electrodes deep into the cochlear nerve, and you could actually send the signal so brain can process it.